In this chapter, we will learn how to use HTTP methods for CRUD operation, which means create, read, update, and delete operations. Now, we have already seen how to convert any function into a RESTful web service using four simple steps. In this chapter also, you will see that we are using same four steps to create our web service. You will also learn how to send back the response in XML and JSON format. To start with, I have written a base project here. It's a plain Java code. It has nothing to do with web service. In this project, there is a class called StudentRegister, which has four functions: getStudentDetails, updateStudentDetails, createStudentDetails, and deleteStudentDetails. All these functions are making use of this text file, which has student records. It has roll number, name, and age. GetStudentDetails is taking roll number integer as the input parameter, and it is returning the record of that student which is having this roll number. UpdateStudentDetails, it takes student as the input parameter, and it updates the record of that student in this text file in studentregister.txt. CreateStudentDetails takes student object as the input parameter, and it creates a new record in that text file, and since that new record should have a new roll number, so it returns that roll number as the response. DeleteStudentDetails, as the name suggests, it takes integer roll number as the input parameter, and it deletes the student record which is having this roll number. It is making use of read file and write file method. You can see the code once you download it. I have also defined two objects, roll number and student. Student object is having roll number, name, and age as their fields. Also, I have defined one more object called roll number. Now, you may think why I am defining a different object for roll number. The reason is that this student register class has a function called createStudentDetails. Now, I could always have returned an integer here, but I'm going to promote this function as a web service. And in a web service, I want my response to be in XML format. And for me to be able to return the response in XML format, I need to have an object so that I can annotate it with JAXP annotation. Now that our base project is ready, we will expose the functions of student register class as RESTful web services. You already know that there are four steps to do that. First step is to copy JAX RS jars in the class path of this project, which here I have already done. Second step is to annotate this class and functions. To do that, let us first import javax.ws.rs.core package. Next, we will annotate the class with path annotation. And you know that you use path annotation to define the URI address of this resource. Here we will give its value as student details. It is recommended that you use noun as address so that when you use it in conjunction with HTTP method, it will clearly state what you are looking for. For example, get student details clearly tells that you want the details of the student. Next, now let us annotate functions. GetStudentDetails is just read operation, so you will use get annotation. We want value of roll number to be sent as part of the URI instead of request body. So this can be achieved by defining the variable in curly brace in path annotation. So you will write roll number, you will give some name here in path annotation, and you give the same name in path param and associate it with the input parameter. So this will ensure that roll number is not part of, you don't need roll number as part of request XML, but it will come as a part of URI. Next is update student details, which is of course a put operation, so you will write put annotation here. Similarly, create student details is post operation, so write post method. And then for delete student details, you will use delete annotation. Now, as I said, that role number will be part of URI, so there is no request XML, there is no consumption of request, but this is only producing the response. So you will use produces annotation here, and you will define the media type, and we want the response to be in XML format, so you will define media type as application XML. Similarly, this method is taking input as student request, which we want in the form of XML, so you will use consumes annotation. And then this post method is consuming also and producing also. It is consuming request XML of a student, so you will write consumes and media type XML. Similarly, you will have to write produces annotation because it is sending the response role number in the form of XML. So that's it, and that completes JAX-RS annotation of our pack class and methods. Next is you will have to annotate the Java bean using JAXB annotation. So I will use here XML root element, which tells that student is the root, will be the root element of the XML. You can change it to any name by using the name value pair, as you are seeing here. Import the right package, javax.xml.bind.annotation, and then you will have to define accessor type also. So you will use the annotation XML accessor type, and you will define its value as field, which means that all the fields of this Java bean should be part of XML. Then I will use the attribute XML attribute here. XML attribute, which means role number is the attribute of root element student, and then here you can use XML element. So this annotation tells you that name is the element of this XML. Similarly, we will define age also as the element of the XML. So you use XML element annotation here. So this completes the annotation of a student class. We will do similar annotation for role number class. So all the things that you did for student. So here also, you will define a root element, XML root element. So your role number will be the root element. And the field integer role number is the XML element. So write the annotation here, XML element. So this completes JAXB annotation of our Java bean class. Next is we will have to register the class, our resource class, in the application class, so that we can override get classes and get singletons, as you have seen in the hello world task. So here I am defining a class app config, and you know that this you need to extend from application class, which is your javax.ws.rs.core.application class, and you have to override two functions, get classes and get singletons, which return the set of classes and set of objects. So first you will define these two fields here. So set classes is equal to new hash set, and then define the second field, create the object for the second field, which is set object. We will name it as singletons. This is equal to new hash set object. Now you need to override get classes and get singletons function. So let's import Java util package. Public set class, get classes. This returns set of classes, so return classes. Similarly, public set object get singletons, and this will return set of singleton objects. So get singletons. Now you are overriding these functions, so you will use override annotation. Now the question is, should we register the classes in get classes functions, or should we create an object and register that object in get singletons? We know that when you register your class in get classes function, then it means that each request will have its own object. But when you create the object and register in get singletons, it means that all the requests at a time will have only one object. Now if you see your student register class, it is consuming the request in the form of some data. So if more than one request will write on the same object, of course it will give an inconsistent result. So you must have one object for each request. So to do that, you should register your class in get classes method. So we will do this classes dot add student register dot class, and the last part is that you give application path annotation, and you know that the value given here is the base URI for all the resources registered in this class. So this completes the fourth and final step. Now we will build the project. And to use this web service, I'm using advanced REST client from Chrome. You know how to structure your URI. So HTTP localhost 8080, then name of the var file. Here it is using CRUD, and then base URI from your application class. Here it is services. So you will copy services, and then the class the class which is having the functions which you want to expose as a REST web service. So value of path annotation there, and then you want role number as part of URI. So I will just use role number 2. If you see this file, role number 2 corresponds to Greg and age 18. So if I send this request, you are seeing the response that we are getting. So it is working good. Now let us try post method. So for post method, you don't need that input as 2. The URI should not have the role number, because role number will be generated by post method and it will be returned. Now you need a body for request. You can copy this one because object is same. Now click on send. Oh, there is an error. So let's see what's happening there. Okay, it has actually added one more record. So means that server side operation was okay. There was problem while sending the response. Here is the problem. We forgot to have this XML accessor type. XML accessor type annotation here. And because of this, when it was forming the response, it failed, though it updated the file, though it created a new record in the file. So let's build and deploy it again. And try this post method once again. Good. So now you got the response. You are seeing that a new role number is created, role number 5, and it is returned in the response. Now come to put operation, put method. For this also you need request body, you need a roll number also, so that you can tell that which roll number you want to update. So let's say we want to update roll number 4, okay, and we want to change something in the record in the roll number 4, so change it to roll number 4 and change the name from Greg to say Dave, and then click on the send button. So the expectation is that response will be empty because there is nothing to be produced, and you can see that this record got updated. Now coming to the delete operation. For delete, we know that we are sending roll number as part of URI. If you see, here we forgot to use path param annotation. So let us copy it from get operation. And then path param. Okay, now you can use, let's first build and deploy this project. Now you can use roll number as part of URI. So let's decide which record we want to delete. Suppose we want to delete record with roll number 5. So in the URI, give this number as 5 and then send. The response is empty. Let's go to the file. You can see that it has deleted the record with roll number 5. So in this chapter, we learned how to use all the 4 HTTP methods in CRUD operation. We also learned how to create request and response in the form of XML for REST web services.